Don't kill civilians, but only drain their blood, otherwise you will be revealed for 60 seconds. This will happen also if you will drain the blood of a civilian close to another civilian. Anyway, once this happens, the citizens will automatically reveal your position on the map, making you an easy target for the other players. At the beginning of each level, try to find immediately an armor piece. Usually they are found in the police car's trunks. Once you have it, equip it in order to have extra 50 health. You can equip the armor and use all the healing and support items without opening your inventory. To know what keys are bound to each action is enough to open your inventory and check above every single icon. At the end of the starting location selection, you will see for 3 seconds where the other players will spawn. Go to the pharmacy building in order to find a lot of healing items like syringes and blood sacks. But be careful, once you open the door, it will trigger the alarm that can attract the other players' attention. Inside the pharmacy, there are 4 panels that hide the healing items. Also in the map, you can see where the pharmacy are. And if you want, you can even choose to spawn nearby. If you can scan the environment, you will notice several people that will be colored by 4 different colors. Consuming them will give you permanent bonuses till the end of the game. Each ability has up to 3 tiers, and to increase it is enough to consume other people of the same aura. By default, you can absorb only 3 souls at the beginning of the game. But each time you will kill any other player by consuming their blood, your limit will increase by 1. Therefore, to max out all the abilities, you need to execute 9 kills in total. But before killing someone first, you need to choose which abilities to learn first based on your playstyle. People with the Azure Aria will decrease your ability cooldown. In my opinion, it is the best when you master the abilities of the character you will play. Next, the people with the purple area will decrease the cooldown of the scan environment. That is really important to get more information about your surroundings. Then there are some people with the pink area that will increase your passive health regeneration. Great to have on characters that cannot easily heal. To finish, there are also people with the orange aura that will increase your melee damage up to 50%. This one is must to have if you like the melee approach. In the map you can notice some entities location signed by the crosses. Here you will find several elite NPC soldiers. Defeating them can give you access to a powerful loot like better assault rifle and silenced SMGs. Another reason why you may consider defeating them is because they guard a crate that will be highlighted by an orange aura while you scan it. Inside them you will find a higher rarity weapons in the game. Search for some ambulance cars and check their trunk. This is because you will usually find a lot of medical items like syringes and blood sacks. Crossbows with the green arrow are really powerful because they will generate a poisonous AoE that will slow down the enemy. Also, it's one of the easiest and safer ways to take out the entity soldiers. In a normal fight against another player, you can shoot a crossbow arrow on top of the enemy, then switch to the secondary weapon to finish him. Keep in mind that if the enemy gets too close to you, shoot the environment immediately with this crossbow. This is because the green gas won't deal damage to you and will help to confuse the enemy. If you want a character that will make it easy to get the entity loot, I suggest you to try the Saboteur. This character, if you will crouch, becomes completely invisible to NPCs after a few seconds, allowing you to get the best loot they have directly without fighting the soldiers. Without speaking that you won't attract the attention of the other players by looting these areas. Another reason why you should consider playing with the Saboteur from the beginning until you won't reach a good understanding of the game is because of his first skill that will make you invulnerable and readily fast for a few seconds. Perfect to escape the enemy if you will get too low on health. A huge combo with this character can be done with the other ability while you are escaping. This is because the enemy can track your direction, so after it ends, use immediately the other ability. That will place a mine that will explode if the enemy enters in the area. This bomb is really powerful and it will completely destroy the enemy shield after the blast. Plus, it deals massive damage over time like the crossbow. In case you get down and after you exit the first skill effect, but you was able to place down the bomb in time, giving you some time to get up and fight back. If you like close combat and want to have an advantage on the enemies, well, you can start from Divine Disco. Here you can find the best building where you can fight in close combat with other players. There are three entrances on the bottom floor and two stairs going up. Considering the building is huge and has a lot of room to move, it is the best to 1v1 without other players coming in time before the fight will end. But to use at maximum the area advantage, you need to play with the Prowler character. This is because you can go upstairs and use the second skill in the middle of the upper floor entrance. This will tag any enemy that will try to get upstairs. Considering that players are always exploring in a hurry, they easily will fall inside your trap. So you can stay here and camp for potential enemies. Considering that this area is inside a building, it is usually rare that someone will get inside. This means that if you are lucky enough, you can get in the top 10 by just waiting. You also don't have to worry about the area that gets shrinked. This is because usually it will take 2 gas shrinks to get to this location. A little extra tip about the Divine Disco location. Get upstairs and go to the left and you will find the secret chest that has a high rarity items inside. You can switch the fire mode on the weapons by pressing B on PC. This is a powerful tool in particular with the sniper rifles. Keep in mind that to work, the sniper rifles must be fully automatic to allow you to switch to this mode. The most common one is called the Toggler. Anyway, switching the mode on the sniper rifle will result in a burst of bullets that deals massive damage due to its heavy bullets type. This means that in this mode you can use the sniper rifle as an assault rifle, but with the higher damage output and lower clip size. If you want some special weapons, there are a few more crates like the one from the Divine Disco. But this time you need to start from the parking garage. The first chest is in the bottom left building, where you have to reach its top location to find the chest. This is the only area that has 2 special chests in it. In fact, the second one is above the building you can find in the top right in the map. In case you want to play more aggressively, a good character to choose is Siren thanks to its second ability. This one is really powerful because it will blind the enemy close to you. The enemy still can shoot you, but he can see where he is aiming. So, a good way to destroy your opponent is to use the fast burn sniper rifles or the SMGs. In the meantime you kill the enemy, it is important to move in an evasive way to decrease the probability of getting hit. But you also can use your first skill in order to move behind the enemy during the fight. Another trick with this character is to use the second skill in order to confuse the enemy. Immediately after, follow it by a poisonous shot with a ballista. This combo will completely blind the enemy, allowing you to deal with him easier. The last trick about this character is that you can use the second skill in order to stop someone from absorbing another player's soul. Really important in order to get one extra kill if you arrive at the end of a fight. Speaking about where to find great loot, the next location you can spawn on is in front of the terrace. From here, climb immediately on top of the building you will see behind you. Then climb over the first wall as well to get in the terrace area. Near the wall you crossed, you will find the special crate with the rare equipment inside. On the walls you also can find a lot of extra equipment and utility items you can collect as well. In case you are down and you are above the roof, try to jump down. Usually on the roof there are a lot of other players, therefore you may save yourself this way. Plus, it is hard to find you if the enemy don't see you fall down. Next great loot location is the Burning Church. Get to its top left corner at the beginning. From here, climb it in order to get to the Burning Church side. Careful because the flames can damage you. You can enter inside the attic thanks to the holes in the roof, where beside the other loot, check behind the support pillar, where you will find the special hidden chest to loot. Time for another good starting location that is in the bottom right corner of the map. Here you can find the antenna. After you will spawn, turn around and climb the building behind you. In the distance you will notice the antenna, and going in its direction you can find several good loot. While climbing it, you can find another secret box that contains a great weapon. Aiming with the biggest part of the rifles while falling down from a building will slow down the fall. This will help you to shoot the enemies below without touching the ground. In the bottom left of the map there is a harbor and the access to the water. But be careful, don't jump inside the water. Because considering that the vampires cannot swim, you will instant die. Using the scan mode, you can see where the potential loot is that will be highlighted by a blue color. Another utility of the scan mode is to understand where the enemies are. The easier way to find them is to use the scan while you hear some shooting. In fact, if the shots was made by the players and not by NPCs, you will see a vibrating circle. This will guide you in the direction from where the enemy was shooting. By looking at the map, you also can spot the enemies that are shooting that will be shown by a red flag sign on their last shoot location. In case any player was identified as a vampire by a civilian, for the whole 60 second duration of the mouse, everyone can see his position in the map. Plus, it will be shown as a red shadow in the distance to help you to find him without using the map. In case your graphical settings are low and you cannot see the shadow, use the little red dot above on the compass. Speaking about the Siren and Moose characters, they have the first ability that will allow you to teleport to a distant location. This ability can be used to speed up the exploration and reach higher places without climbing. Every character has a passive hidden ability. For this trick, I explained the Brute one. That will heal you up to half of your health once you get out of combat. This is a really powerful survival skill, considering that it will help you after each fight to not be too low on health. Or if you start escaping in the middle of the battle, you will heal yourself before turning back and fighting again, defeating possibly the wounded enemy that doesn't have the same advantage. In the graphical settings, increase your view distance to ultra. If you need it for the performance, decrease other parameters. This is really important because the view distance influences how far your scan will propagate. Also, the enemies that was witnessed by civilians will be shown even further away. Without saying that you will see further, and it is really important when you are on top of a roof to see the enemies that are far away and snipe them down. Speaking about sniping, usually in the antenna chest you will find a precision rifle. That is perfect to one-shot enemies that don't have the shield. One of the best characters as a sniper is Saboteur. Because thanks to his invis while crouching, it becomes impossible to find it on high locations. The antenna isn't the best for this job. In fact, once you have the sniper rifle, it's better to go to the construction or demolition sites, where you can find several cranes to use for this purpose. You can identify their location easier by looking at the map, considering that they will be represented by a straight line. There is a little trick to move faster. To do so, start sprinting, then at the maximum speed, crouch in order to start sliding. Before the slide animation will end, execute a jump. Then, before you will touch the ground, you have to crouch again. This will loop the fast slide animation. In the meantime, if you will keep the sprint button pushed, you will move really fast. Perfect to escape if you are losing a fight or get to the enemy faster. Check in the map where you can see the pistol icon. This represents that in this location you will find a gun shop. To visit it, you have to find the entrance door that you can open. But be careful, because doing so will trigger an alarm that will last for a few seconds. Inside this shop you can open 4 wall shelves, inside each of which you can find several weapons and in some cases even armor. In the map, while choosing the starting location, you can notice several high-tier loot text. This means that in the area around the text, you will find the items with a higher rarity than in the other sides of the city. Plus, it also will raise the probability to find legendary items from the special chests. Speaking about these chests, you can find another one by starting above the sky bar location. Once inside the map, check the skyscraper to the left from you. You have to climb on top of it. In the center on the left, you will find the huge attic bar with the main structure you have to explore. In fact, behind the black monolith, you can find the secret crate to loot. Another one can be found in the helipad location. The fastest way to get up here is from the bottom side of the building in the map, where you will have the building in front of you. So just climb it all the way up until you will find a helicopter parking. In the middle of it, you can find the secret box to loot. In my personal opinion, the best starting location is between the sky bar and the shopping arcade areas. This is because once spawned, go toward the shopping arcade that will be on your right. Once inside, stay on the left until you will find the secret container. Next, go a little bit further, staying on the left until you can rob the weapon shop, where you will find for sure some good weapons and even armors. To finish, go a little bit back in order to visit the pharmacy shop, where you will be able to max out on healing items. Now that you looted all you need to fight, it's time to win the game. But let's suppose that you want the best possible melee weapon. For this reason, you have to check the gun shop above the restaurant signed with a knife in the map, where you usually will find the best melee weapons in the game, including a katana if you are lucky enough. Another good starting point is above the art gallery. Once inside the game, turn around and use the wall to get on top of the building. Then go straight until you will get to several red umbrellas. Here, turn to the right in order to enter inside the art gallery building, where immediately to the left, you will find a secret chest to loot in order to have a chance to find a legendary or other good weapons. One of the best weapons is the pump action shotgun. This is because it deals massive damage and usually with 2 or 3 shots it defeats any enemy in close range. Just use the scan every time you hear someone shoot and go there trying to sneak behind the enemy. Also, if someone with an assault rifle will try to defeat you, run away and make him think that you are low on HP. This will allow you to channel him in a tunnel, for example, where he has limited movement. This way, you can easily defeat him. Speaking of the previous melee weapon shop, get to the same spawn point to find another good area to loot. In fact, once here, start climbing toward the rooftop restaurant. From the roof with flowers, proceed further, then down. This will allow you to access the attic of the restaurant. Check immediately under the big red tent, where you will find another special chest that contains the best weapons in the game. Another interesting area is in the middle of the demolition location. After starting the game, climb immediately over the blue wall to the left. Then keep the left until a ramp of blue containers you have to use in order to reach the room slightly above. To finish, climb over the next wall as well and you will find the secret chest on the other side. Next area where you might consider spawning is in the left from the Rudolphium location. From here, go along the building until you will find a parking entrance. Crouch to pass through the garage door, then check to the left side of the parking, where you will find the secret chest to loot. Time to visit the university garden. Once spawned in the middle of the location, turn around and climb the building behind you. Next, stay on the right until you reach the edge of the roof, where you will find a terrace with 2 benches and a secret chest in between them. Next good location to start from is in the right from the harbor, where you have to turn around and follow the walkway along the river all the way till the end. Next, climb over the building with the glowing text in front of it. This will lead you to another walkway along the river. Get all the way till the bridge and use the staircase going down to the right. Next, check near the right white electrical panel in order to find a special chest to loot. Now, it's time to get to the bottom of the slaughterhouse. From where, you have to turn to the left and enter inside the building. Next, climb the wall to the left in order to reach the storage shelves. In the bottom right of the second one, you can loot the secret chest. One of many good weapons you can find is the silenced SMG. This is a good weapon to use if you don't want other players to see your position by scanning the area for shots. You actually can use this weapon to free the entity areas without attracting too much attention. Speaking about the soldiers that defend these areas, once you kill them, they actually will do the downed player animation for 3 seconds. If you drain their blood during this period, you will heal yourself. Perfect to complete the clearing of the area. But be careful, any shot of other NPCs will stop the drain, so do this only once you kill them all. Inside the Asylum, you can enter inside the player menu, from where you have to browse in the archetypes. Inside this tab, you can check every single character, their active abilities and passive one as well. Keep in mind that passive abilities cannot be seen in your inventory, so it is important to check all the passive of each character to learn more about how to play against other players and how to maximize your character potential. A little note, by using the play video button, you will see a demonstration of the ability. This is handy to understand how to use it and face against it. If you like to try a melee playstyle, the right choice is to pick the Vandal character, mainly for its passive ability that will decrease all damage you take if you will get close to any enemy. Next, you need a good melee weapon from the beginning of the game. The trick explained before to spawn near the melee weapon shop can do the trick. Next, you have to find the humans with the orange aura in order to drain their power. This is because it will drastically increase your melee damage up to 50%. Take your time to get some healing items and you're ready to go. Now, the melee strategy with this character is to find any enemy, jump above him with the first skill, and immediately after use the other ability that will move you to the enemy location and stun him for a second. This is a great opportunity to start melee your opponent to death. Speaking again about the entity locations, the soldiers you will kill here are the only one that has the burst rifle. The speciality of this weapon is that you can change its fire type, changing from one shot to a burst. In burst mode, it will shoot 3 bullets with one click. The problem is that it has a high recoil, so it is better to use this mode in close fights, while the single shot mode makes your aim precise like a sniper rifle. But if you want the best weapon in the game, you have to loot the special crates that are guarded by these entity soldiers. This is because inside them you have a good chance to find the minigun, that literally can defeat an enemy with max health in 2 seconds. The only disadvantage of this weapon is that despite it has 300 bullets, it cannot be reloaded. While exploring these dangerous areas, in case the entity soldiers will down you, you can hide behind any obstacle in order to stop their weapon's laser trajectory. If you will manage to do so, they will stop shooting at you and won't get closer, allowing you to get up. Speaking about the ballistas with poison, they are great to confuse the enemy and at the same time deal poison damage. But if you want to literally kill your opponent or entity soldiers, be sure to shoot in the enemy body as well. This is because it will deal 100 damage on impact, plus the poison damage will finish the enemy. At the beginning of the game, you won't have time to find great weapons. So, check in the map, the closest enemy you see, and get to him as fast as possible. If you will be able to find him, don't use any weapon, switch immediately to your melee that will be fists. Despite the fists don't deal a lot of damage, it is still enough to defeat someone easily if he will try to shoot you instead of fighting in melee as well. If you will find a sniper rifle with a precision scope, my personal advice is to go to the burning church and enter inside the location described before to find the secret loot. This is because from the two broken sides you can see the biggest part of the roofs are round. Considering that this always is a hotspot because of several important loot locations, you will find a lot of people moving up here. The cool thing about sniping from this location is that people cannot see you easily because of the fire smoke that covers the vision. Without speaking about the fire around the building that can damage the enemy that will get to you in a hurry. There is a broken character that will allow you to easily win any game. Obviously, I speak about the Moose. This is because he has a broken passive ability that will allow you to use your first ability after you get down. The broken part of this ability is that enemies won't be able to see in which direction you are gone, allowing you to escape, in particular if you get downed after a fight while trying to drown the enemy player. Another reason why the Moose character is really powerful is because of its second skill as well. This is because once you get too low on health, you can use it in order to restore your maximum health. The ability will keep healing you till the maximum. It can be stopped by you if you use an interaction button or by the enemy if he will shoot you. This means that you can fully restore your health without even searching for any humans to drain. One of many loot you can find is the red gas neutralizer. This item is really important to survive in the end game, because once used, it will protect you for several seconds from the red gas. So once used, you won't take any damage, staying outside of the playable area. In late game, it will help a lot to win. In fact, you can use it to absorb the enemy you downed close to the borders. This item effect will protect also your shield. If you mastered all that I explained before, you will be able to get to the 1v1 moment. To win it easily, you need to spot the enemy first. To do so, find a way where you can hide and have the red smoke behind you. This way, you are sure that the enemy can come only from one direction, that is in front of you. Now, wait until he will get close to you, and then surprise him. Now, wait until he will get close to you, then ambush him before he will see you. With characters like Moose that can teleport to the enemy will make your life easier if you were able to find a katana during the gameplay and max it your melee damage as well.